Well, it's that time of the year again. The leaves are about all gone, the walnuts are falling off, and so I've got to get busy on my process here, picking up some of these walnuts. There are not too many under this tree, but that one down there, you got several. Most of the walnuts are pretty small. It's just unhandy that way. I'd rather they'd be bigger, but anyway, we'll have to get busy here in just a minute and see what we got going.
Yeah, I got this thing here, makes it kind of handy, because otherwise you got to be bending over all the time. It's bad enough just to stand around here and do this, but the squirrel's already got that.
Well, that's the gist of that, and then we take them back here and put them in the back of our little pickup truck here. That guy's cutting the grass over there, so he's getting ready to kind of, this is a different guy that owns this, but after he bought this, I think he wondered why in the heck he did, because it's a real relic. I think they're going to tear it down. I don't know for sure just yet, but it's a mess the way it is. All right, we'll get back at it later on here. Them little buckets, three buckets there, is all I got out of them. Can't see in there very good, but there's some maggots on some of them. They kind of, they don't bother me too much. They don't bother me at all, actually, because they're not going to hurt nothing else. All right, well, that's enough of this. I got to get busy and go get some more walnuts down the back and a few other things, so we'll get back to you later.
All picked up. Well, of course, I'm not going to all picked up. Then you got to do this little process here, which are kind of up in the way there, so take off the rind of the husk. I guess they call them holes. And that part is a messy job. That old goo will be a little bit for long, but one of the rare times I'll wear gloves. And there's generally a lot of maggots in there. Well, that's about as easy to do as anything. You can run over with a lawnmower or something. And I'll get these husks off here better, but I don't really need to know this rotten mic. This thing just come right off. Later on, I'll get down some of them. I probably need to have take a hammer to chop them up, but as of now, they work pretty good. Later on, we'll go into a pressure wash the walnuts and get all this old scuzzy stuff off here. You can see it or not, but anyway, we'll get that all taken care of. And then we got to crack them after that. And then we're all just kind of painting the rear empty, but you got to do it if you like walnuts. Anyway, you probably get the idea how this works, and I must go on continuing on for a long time with that. So, we'll turn the camera off, and I'll continue on with this drudgery here. I can find a place to turn the camera off, and got all kind of goo all over my fingers. I'll probably get a dirty bath using this undercarriage attachment from a pressure washer. We're going to give it a try and see what happens. that zero nozzle, because this don't seem to be working out. Let's see if I can really get the bladders. Well, they may not be perfect, but they're perfect enough for me. A whole lot better than it was before. I don't think there's a maggot left in there. So now the next process of this is going to be, there's a dirty one right there. Anyway, we're going to leave them dry out maybe a month or two before I crack them, because they got to be seasoned inside or dried out inside, whatever you want to call it. All right, well, I guess that's it for this process here. It'll be a while before we finish up cracking and checking them out and everything. So, thanks for watching, subscribing, and thumbs up if you would.